Hey, the Mad Hermit here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to get this swagadelic baller hat that's only available to players in Shroud of the Avatar Pre-Alpha Release 10. This hat features the new virtue symbol, which is the Infinity Cross, and can be obtained by going on something called the Grand Tour, which entails visiting 6 new areas of content and meeting up with a tour guide. The goal of this is to encourage players to seek out and explore new areas while at the same time coming back to each pre-alpha release. So expect to see something like this again in future pre-alpha releases. If you've already pledged to Shroud of the Avatar or are thinking about pledging, keep in mind that there is an Alienware $20 pledge upgrade available. Just by clicking a link. It's pretty simple. I'll add that link below. And again, this works for existing or new players. Also, depending on your pledge level, keep in mind that $20 in many cases is a full pledge upgrade. All right, so let me show you how to go about acquiring the rare Cavalier's hat in pre-alpha release 10. Immediately after creating your character, you're going to start off in Braemar. And as you can see off to the left of the screen, there are 2 portals. And in front of those portals is a tour guide. Double-clicking the tour guide starts the quest. And what you're essentially going to have to do is find this tour guide in 6 different locations. The Castle of the Mountain, the Castle of the Winds, the Oracle Confirmatory, Virtus Pass, the spectator area of the PvP team arena, and the challenge dungeon. Now, the order of these locations is not important, so we're going to take advantage of the fact that 2 of those locations are right here. So let's go into the challenge dungeon. The other portal, by the way, is the PvP arena, but we'll come back to that. Now, as soon as we teleport to the challenge dungeon, we'll see our happy tour guide here, and we can double-click him, and you'll see that it says, "Your progress is recorded. Good luck on the rest of the grand tour." Now, you can press forward and explore, which I encourage you to do, but I'm going to double back and show you how to get to the various checkpoints, if you will. Behind Dreadlord Steven is the PvP arena, and once you're here, you're going to want to go through the Omniscient Oracle Eye and through the portal. Once you make it through the portal, you're going to be on the visitor's deck of the PvP arena, which is new. Of course, right when you cross through the door, you see there's the tour guide. You can interact with him and get the next part of your quest completed. And again, that's done simply by double-clicking him, which you can confirm by looking at the "Your progress is recorded" text that appears in the chat window. What's new about this space is you can look, but you can't touch. So you can watch the PvPers battle it out, but you cannot participate, you cannot heal anyone, and you are merely a spectator. All right, when you're done lollygagging, you can head back through the portal and make your way back to the surface. And you're just going to do everything you did to get down here in reverse to accomplish that. Once you're back on the surface, you're going to want to get out of Braemar because we've completed everything we needed to here. The next stop on our trip is Arteris, and we are going to walk through the overland map here, and this is a great opportunity to enjoy the new visuals, and the your avatar now is seen traversing the map. One thing different in this release is that you control your character with the mouse keys. WASD is how you move your avatar around. Don't be confused by my mouse that looks like it's navigating my character. All right, we're at Kingsport, and Kingsport is how we're going to get to Arteris. So we are going to go to one of these little skiffs located on the docks and double-click the one that's on the far right. It'll actually tell you this is passage to Arteris if you hover your mouse over it. In Arteris, we have 3 meeting points. Let's first get our bearings. We are here. We're also going to need to go to the Castle of the Mountain, which is on the west side. And directly opposite that is the Castle of the Winds. And then in the north center of Arteris is the Oracle Confirmatory. Just a quick heads up, I was playing with my video quality settings in Arteris, and I actually set them to low. And right here, you're going to see I'm going to kind of set them back to fantastic. Unfortunately, the settings don't take until I switch scenes. So what you're looking at is a low video quality settings in Arterus. So forgive me for that. Anyway, here we are at the Castle of the Mountain, and you're going to go through those big, ginormous doors, and we're going to look for our favorite little guide, and there he is. You're going to walk up to your tour guide, and you're going to double-click him, and there you go. Your progress is recorded. Good luck on the rest of the grand tour. So let's continue. From here, we're going to make our way to the center of town. Now, if you look way off into the distance, you're going to see the opposing castle. We need to get there too, but halfway between here and there is the Oracle Confirmatory. And when you see the Titan Sequana, you'll know that you're in the right place. You're going to veer off to the right here and go back, and you will see the Oracle. And inside the Oracle is our tour guide, where we can then click him, get the next part of the quest, or complete it rather. And if you want, you can linger and interact with the Oracle. But if not, you can journey onward and go to the Castle of the Winds. There you will find our all too familiar tour guide. You'll click him, lather, rinse, repeat, and complete this part of the grand tour. Once you're done, you're going to head back to the skiff that brought you here, which will then take you to Kingsport. From Kingsport, you will exit the city, which will take you on the overland map, and you will journey northward to Owl's Head. There we'll be using the Lunar Rift to take us to Virtus Pass, our final destination. Keep in mind, these quests aren't designed to be lateral thinking puzzles that challenge your wits, but rather a way for the developers to encourage players to come and play the pre-alphas so they can get some valuable test data. Alright, once at Owl's Head, you're going to double-click it from the overland map, and you'll see that there's a Lunar Rift off to the left. You're going to want to approach this Lunar Rift and hover your mouse cursor over it to see where it's currently going. Right now it says the Graph Gem Mines. We want to go to Veritas Pass. So what we're going to do is do a /AFK and sit here and wait. This is the only way to get there, and you're going to want to wait until the portal shifts to a new destination. Now it shifts every 5 minutes. Alternatively, what you can do is you can zone, /zone to a player that you know is already there. And that's what I did. Community member Licemeat was kind enough to allow me to zone to him. Once at Veritas Pass, you will see your tour guide waiting for you. Double click him and you'll see that you've completed the grand tour, and the Cavalier's hat shall be yours. He says, congratulations. And now you see a reward item has been added to your account. And the item added to your inventory is the armor /port musketeer hat 01. And they wrote this news in my journal. My journal's been updated. Hitting J, by the way, brings up your journal where you can see all the information about this quest, what you've completed, what's still outstanding, all that good stuff. Lastly, you're going to want to hit I for your inventory. Look for the Cavalier's hat that's in your equipment. Drag that onto your paper doll, which you launch by hitting C. And your character will be rocking that hat like a gangster. Anyway, I'm out of time. Remember, Pre-Alpha Release 10 is live right now and ends Monday, September 29th at 10 a.m. Central Time. I'm going to leave a link to Sir Style Tekel's Shroud of the Avatar quick reference card. It has all the commands you're going to need to help get you through Shroud of the Avatar. Anyway, I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you have questions or comments, leave them below, and I'll see you next time.